In this video, we'll design ventilation system. Open the ventilation discipline. We are going to start designing the second floor. By default, duct network toolbox opens in the ventilation discipline. Switch to building toolbox. Click in suspended ceiling function. The suspended ceiling function is a grid with a given height where we can insert products such as air terminals. To insert a suspended ceiling in a room, simply left mouse click inside the room. You can also insert the suspended ceiling in the first and ground floor rooms. Go back to Duct Network Toolbox to have access to ventilation functions again. Activate Air Terminal function. To open the Air Terminal product database, left mouse click the three dots button. All products in DDS-CAD are sorted by filters and subfilters on the left. In Supply Filter, select the Ceiling Diffuse Round subfilter without plenum. Select the 200 cubic meter per hour diffuser. A preview picture of the product displays on the low left corner. The airflow can be manually edited. At this duct drop-down list, the mounting height can be fixed at the suspended ceiling, ceiling, floor, or free. When the configurations are done, click OK. We can insert the diffuser dynamically. To snap the air terminals on a suspended ceiling grid, certify useSnapPoints function is activated. We are going to place some supply air diffusers in the rooms with suspended ceiling. As an introduction video, we are not concerned about the precise amount of air for each room. Open Air Terminal Product Database once again. Open Extract Filter. Select Air Valve and Ceiling Subfilter. Next, select the first product in the list. The extract air diffusers will be inserted in the two toilets. We are going to design some ducts in our model. Activate duct function, then right mouse click at the position you want to start your duct. In start from, you choose how to start the duct. The mounting height can be manually inserted at the start mounting height blank. In the medium group and type drop-down list, you choose the duct system. Switching the duct from circular to rectangular or oval, the product database is automatically changed. Click OK to start drawing the duct. Go upwards until the air terminal center line in the left. Left mouse click to insert a band, then move the duct over the air terminals. Right mouse click to open the context menu, select the option End with Lid. Now, move the mouse cursor to the duct band to convert it to a T. Be sure you use Smart Snaps function is activated. You start drawing the duct from the T, then move it among the ducts and left mouse click to insert bands of 45 degrees. Left mouse click to end the segment, then press S key, which is the End with Lid shortcut. With the duct function still activated, select the duct in the position you want to insert it in. Draw the duct parallel to the supplier terminals, then end with a lid. Position a new duct start point close to the low left corner of the room below. Now change the medium type in the drop-down list to extract air. Draw the duct segment to the left until it reaches the first air valve. Then left mouse click to end the segment. Access the context menu to select the Reducer product database. In the transition dialog, you can set the parameters described in the dimensions picture. Draw the duct segment until it crosses the last air valve. Insert a lid at the duct end with Ctrl-S shortcut. Now select any diffuser, then open the context menu. Select the option Select Object as the one selected. Make a selection window from the low left corner to the upright corner with all diffusers included. Open the context menu again and select the option Automatic Connection. You can automatically connect diffusers to rectangular or circular ducts. There are many available options of connection types. After you have chosen the desired connection, click OK. Now we are going to duplicate this current ventilation system to the stories below. To select only the ventilation system, activate Layer Display. Select Building from Type drop-down list. Select all the layers and lock them. Now they are unable to be selected. Select all ventilation components. Right mouse click to open the context menu, then select the option Copy objects by free reference point. Select a reference point. Now open the project manager. Open the first floor. Paste it from context menu or Ctrl-V shortcut. Do the same thing for the ground floor. Go back to the second floor. Insert an air handling unit. You can select a 500 cubic meter per hour from house ventilation filter. Note there is a 12 cm of mounting height. You can rotate the product with counterclockwise from context menu. Activate Duct function to start routing ducts from the air handling. Draw the fresh air duct until the external wall. Open the context menu to end with an air terminal. Select a weatherproof louvre of 200 mm size. Do the same for the exhaust air. End with an air terminal with a key shortcut. Select an air outlet 45 degrees steel of 200 mm size. Go to render mode to see these terminals. Activate Duct function once more. Draw the extract air duct from the air handling unit until the up left corner of the room. Press Page Down, then go to Floor button. Do the same for the supply air. With duct function still activated, move the mouse cursor to the extract air duct below. Check whether Use Smart Snaps is activated. Draw the duct until the extract air duct coming from the air handling unit. Connect Ducts dialog shows automatic connection options. Now, do the same for the supply air duct. Go to the first floor. Activate view connections from above. Activate duct function once more. Click on duct column sign. Click on go to floor button. Do the same for supply. Click again on the column sign to insert AT in a certain height. At absolute height, write down 3.10 meters. Route this pipe until the start point of the extract air below. You can use helplines while drawing. Activating helplines, the original function remains in standby. Access context menu for helplines options. Press escape to get back to the original function. The duct we want to connect is 160 mm. Insert a reduction from context menu or Y shortcut. Change D parameter to 160 mm. When the helpline is no more useful, you can delete it. Now, do the same for the supplier. Go to ground floor to finish to connect our systems. This time we are going to connect from the column signs to the existing ducts. Now we are going to create a part model. In the list of part models dialog, click on New Part Model button. You can give a name, description, and select the geometry type of the part model. Make a rectangle of the area of the part model. List of part models opens again. On the right, you have a preview of the part model. Right mouse click at the created part list. Select the option to 3D presentation. A 3D part model has been created on DDS Explorer. In part models or sections, follow this path to use render mode functions. Tools from menu bar, part model sections, and render. Check with the other floors. Open Import in Mono Manager. Then click on the tab Ghost Story Discipline. Make sure you have ventilation selected at the discipline drop-down list. Click on the stories you want to ghost, they're turned on with the open eye sign.